Today in this video we are going to see about air prevention, control and prevention of pollution, that is which is very much essential for the protection of environment. And this has been safeguarded by Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1981 and Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Rules 1982, and also by the Environmental Protection Act 1986. These are all the law, act and rules which safeguard the environment, because the air is very much essential for the breathing, for the sustenance of life, are the normal living condition of life. First we will see the earth. The earth is surrounded by the atmosphere, and the atmosphere consists of, immediately the atmosphere consists of, they are surrounded by gases, and over that there are so many spheres are there. Then that is stratosphere, ionosphere, so many spheres are there. But we are very much concerned about the atmosphere, which consists of, that is nitrogen about 80%, and oxygen, 1/5 of oxygen, that is 1/5 of the total gases, oxygen, and the remaining thing is carbon dioxide to the level of 0.3, and the remaining the noble gases, that is helium, neon and argon. So what the percentage should be maintained, and any pollutant, the air is polluted by some pollutants. The pollutant means that is something which is unwanted thing mixes with the atmospheric gases, that is called pollutant. The pollutants are the carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen oxides. These are all certain gases which pollute the air. So the clean air is required, the clean environment for healthy living, and then the ailments which may be caused by the air pollution is respiratory ailments, the breathing trouble, and then so subsequently it may cause the plasticity of lungs, and ultimately it may end the life. So the Article 21 protects the life and liberty, personal liberty of an individual. So the provision has been laid down in the Constitution to provide personal liberty and protection to the life, so that the air should be clean and pure, so that the normal breathing is possible, and the life activity can be normal. So now regarding the case study, Vellore Citizens Welfare Forum versus Union of India, this is 1996 and Supreme Court 2715. In this is a famous case. Actually the public interest litigation was constituted by the Vellore Citizens Forum, and what they constituted, that is the air contains the stale gases, or it is the surrounding air is very filthy, and the stench, smell is stinky because of the release of pollutants such as sulfur dioxide, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, nitrogen oxides, and some of the lead contents, and also even sodium chloride and sulfates, which are used for tannery industries in Vellore area, Vellore, nearer to Vellore area, Amur and Vadiyambadi. And those tanneries are mixing their effluents in the Pala River, which pollutes not only the air but also the land, and also the water. It contaminates the water, so that the public interest litigation was formed in the coat, and then the principle of Peyer's principle was instituted against this case. So whoever pollute the atmosphere, they have to pay for that. They have to clean the air apart from the compensation to the victims. So that was decided like that. So this clearly indicates that the air should be free from all pollutants, and that it is the government's duty to see that the air is very pure, and for that the all effective measures are to be taken. If at all if it is not pure, and if at all if it is polluted by the industries, by the pollutants. Now second thing, air pollution, that is the air which is polluted jeopardizes the plant and animal life, and also it causes bronchitis, cancer, these diseases like bronchitis and cancer in the lung. So apart from that, we have to see something, say something about the ozone layer hole. Actually, the layer, ozone layer is available in the atmosphere, and that ozone layer is polluted by the gases like carbofluorocarbon, which is released from the the air conditioning industries. So the carbofluorocarbon makes hole in the ozone, which causes the ultraviolet rays from the sunlight, and that that is actually absorbed by the ozone layer. If the hole is found in the ozone layer, then it may go through the ozone layer hole, and it will pass on to the atmosphere, and the human being will be suffering due to the skin diseases, because the melanin pigment and other thing is be destroyed by the ultraviolet rays. So we should see that the ozone layer is protected by all means. Now the carbofluorocarbon is banned for the air conditioning industry, and then we have to see when we release a lot of carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen oxide in the atmosphere, which is above the limit, then acid rain may cause. Acid rain means if the carbon dioxide contact with rain, that is water H2O plus CO2, carbonic acid will be formed. Like that, sulfur dioxide plus water, when it combines with water particles, then it will form sulfuric acid. Like that, nitrogen plus water, nitric acid. So the nitric acid to certain extent is can be converted into nitrates in the soil, and if it is over and above, then it is dangerous to the atmosphere. Like that, the sulfur dioxide is also dangerous. This is called acid rain. When the oxides are converted into acid, that corrodes the building, that corrodes the skin of the human being. So it is a dangerous situation. And we have to talk about the another important aspect, global warming. Global warming is also a phenomena which is having very bad effect on the plants and animals. So actually, when they allowed atmospheric carbon dioxide 0.2, and but nowadays the carbon dioxide is increasing due to the global warming. Actually, when we release lot of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, to certain level it is allowed, because it retains the heat. Actually, the sunlight coming from the sun is reaching the ground, and the carbon dioxide absorbs certain heat. So certain heat is required, so that it is allowed. But it is over and above, the carbon dioxide retains the heat, and as such the atmosphere is overheated. That is called global warming. This is dangerous aspect with regard to the human life as well as animal plant life. Apart from that, the Antarctic and Arctic region will also melt, and the sea level will rise. It will inundate some of the islands, and it will inundate some of the land area. It is a dangerous effect, and the permanent Ganga will not be available, because if the glaciers to the kilometer level found in the Himalaya, it may, if all the glaciers melts due to global warming, then we cannot see the Pernal Ganga. During rainy days, we get rainy water. During summer days, we get water in the Ganga by the melting of ice. But all the glaciers melt, we may not get the water during summer days. So this is the called global warming. Then source, what are the source of pollution, air pollution? That is vehicle emission, and some of the power plants also release carbon dioxide, nitrogen oxides, and then flying ash. These are all power plants, and burning wood. When we burn the wood, that also produces the pollutants, carbon dioxide, etc. So the source is vehicle emission, because we use petrol, diesel, and other thing. They emit gases such as sulfur dioxide, nitrogen oxides. And so now what we suggest, the electronic vehicles, and then liquid LPG gases like that, and even battery cars, etc. So the source is three sources: vehicle emission, power plants, and burning woods. And then statutory law, the law controls the power the air pollution, that is Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1891, Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Rules 1982, and then Environmental Protection Act 1986. Then air pollutant. The air pollutant is in the form of solid, liquid, gas, even noise also present in the atmosphere. And the air pollutants are automobile emission, that is industrial plants, and the occupiers also release certain unwanted gases in the atmosphere. That is the by the occupiers, that is by the human being or by the animals. Pollution control board. So in order to have a control over this, control and prevention over pollution, the pollution control boards have been started. That is Central Pollution Control Board and State Pollution Control Board, CPCB and SPCB, by Act. Functions of Central Pollution Control Board. The Central Pollution Control Board administering the air quality, and then the second is nationwide progress of the control of pollution, and the coordination between State Pollution Control Board and Central Pollution Control Board, and technical assistance and guidelines are also given, and abatement of pollution. The pollution is to be removed. For that, all actions are taken by the Central Pollution Control Board. Now we will see the State Pollution Control Board, that is the how the State Pollution Control Board is formed. One chairperson will be there, and the five representatives will be there, and five members also will be functioning. And out of five members, 3% will be represented from agriculture and 2% from state controlled public corporations. Then and one full time secretary will also be there. Functions, it chart out the plan for the control of pollution, prevention of pollution, and then prevention and conservation of air pollution, and then collection of data, what is the available pollution in the air, then and there it is collected, and training is given to the personnel who are working in the, to update the knowledge and to have a better understanding of air pollution. Accordingly, they will act to control the pollution. Then the inspection of various industrial units, so how far the emission is there, and what are the contents of emission like that. So then suitability of any precincts. The precincts and premises of the industries are there. The suitability of that is also surveyed by the state control board, and then establishment of laboratory to find out the quality of the air and the content of air pollution, etc. Then power of the state pollution control board. Then the main important function of the state pollution control board is to grant consent to establish industries. So before that, before establishing industries, it will take all measures, such as whether they have the plant for cleaning of air, and what are the gases will be emitted, and how it can be prevented. Like that, after ascertaining all the things, then the grant will be given. Then challenges and solutions. National Criminal Tribunal is an important tribunal is there. They see that to implement environment law and impose the heavy fines to curb pollution. The important function of the National Green Tribunal is to implement the environmental law, and also to see it pay levies heavy fine who are flouting the norms of pollution. So this is with regard to the air law in India. Tamil air pollution, அதாவது வாயு அஸ்தமாவதை பற்றி பார்க்கின்றோம். இந்த வாயு அஸ்தமாவதற்கு முக்கியமான காரணங்கள், வாயுவிலே நம்ம பூமியை சுற்றி உள்ள அட்மாஸ்பியர் நைட்ரஜன் ஆக்சிஜன் கார்பன் டை ஆக்சைடு இருக்கின்றது. அது அதனுடைய அளவு அதிகமாகும் பொழுது, அல்லது வேறு பொல்யூஷன் அதிகமாகும் போது, பொல்யூஷன் கேசஸ் கார்பன் டை ஆக்சைடோ சல்ஃபர் டை ஆக்சைடோ வேறு லெட் எமிஷனோ இவைகளெல்லாம் அட்மாஸ்பியரில் சேரும் பொழுது அது வாயு பொல்யூஷன் ஆகிறது, தட் இஸ் அஸ்தமாக்குகிறது. அது பிராங்கிட்டிஸ் போன்ற வியாதிகளை உண்டாக்கிறது, கேன்சர் போன்ற வியாதிகளை உண்டாக்கிறது. எனவே அதற்காக பொல்யூஷன் கண்ட்ரோல் போர்டு அமைக்கப்பட்டு அவைகளெல்லாம் வாயு மண்டலத்தை சரிபார்த்து அவர்கள் நடவடிக்கை எடுக்கிறார்கள். தொழிற்சாலையிலிருந்து வரையும் கழிவுகளை பார்த்து அதற்கான நடவடிக்கை எடுப்படுகிறது. இவ்வாறாக பொல்யூஷன் கண்ட்ரோல் போர்டு செயல்பட்டு சரியான நடவடிக்கை எடுக்கின்றது. With this, we conclude this video.